Hi there. I'm Kyle, working on web apps and plugin experiences on the Edge team at Microsoft. Over the last few months, Bing Chat has seen tremendous interest, with over 500 million chats and 100 million daily users interacting with search in a whole new way, supercharging their creativity, and getting straight to answers, thanks to the power of large language models. Over the past few weeks, we've shared more about the next wave of AI innovation across Microsoft, including the Copilot system in Microsoft 365, as well as new and upcoming improvements to the Bing Chat experience, such as multimodal conversation with text and images, more languages, and chat history. Today, we'd like to talk more about how developers can participate in this wave of innovation, thanks to plugins for Bing Chat and other Copilots across Microsoft. Plugins let you teach a language model how to interact with your service, using your new or existing API with endpoints for the language model to call. This lets you augment the capabilities of Copilots and helps connect users with your service to answer their questions or complete their task. We're already working with many new and existing plugin developers to bring their capabilities to chat. We're embracing the same plugin model as OpenAI, making plugins fully compatible across ChatGPT, Bing Chat, and the Microsoft Copilot system. This means that your investments in plugins can reach the widest ecosystem of users, including Microsoft's commercial and consumer Copilot offerings, as well as ChatGPT, with a common approach. All that's needed from you is an open API specification documenting your API and a manifest file that provides the necessary metadata for the plugin. We'll use these assets to help users discover your plugin experiences and engage with them naturally in their conversations. Let's dive into the plugin model in a little more detail. For that, I'd like to turn it over to my colleague, Constantine, from the Bing team.
Hi there, I'm Constantine, and I am a developer on the Microsoft Turing team as part of Bing. I'm thrilled to share some of the exciting new features we're building for Bing Chat. As Kyle said, we're adding plugins to Bing Chat and across Microsoft Copilots using the same plugin model as OpenAI, allowing developers to seamlessly enable their plugins to a whole new set of users. Let's look at an example of what's needed to enable a plugin in Bing Chat. We will be looking at OpenTable, which will soon be available as a plugin for Bing Chat. First, you will need to create a plugin manifest, which provides the necessary metadata for making it discoverable to our users, as well as to the system. Here, you will define things like the name of your plugin, a brief description, the auth needed when invoking the APIs you expose, and other things like the icon to use in the UI when your plugin gets invoked. The description for human is a human-readable description of your plugin and the capabilities used for discoverability purposes, for example, when users are searching for plugins to install. The description for model is used when deciding to call your plugin. It should contain general instructions about your plugin capabilities and how the model should use it. You should use natural language in a concise yet descriptive manner without specifically instructing the model to call your plugin. Because of context length limitations, it's recommended to keep this short, and the exact limits are subject to change as we experiment and learn more. The second step is to define an open API specification that documents how your API works. You will create a standard JSON or YAML document that contains metadata about the APIs you want exposed to the model. You can choose to selectively expose only parts of your API or specific functionality. In this example from OpenTable, we can see that there is only one API exposed, which is the Search Restaurants API. Here, you will add the standard metadata like the specification version, title, or version number. Then you will describe the actual APIs exposed and their parameters. When handling a user query, the model will use a description for each of the APIs to decide if it's relevant to the user query or not. The description should be in natural language and should summarize the functionality provided by the API while keeping it concise, with the exact limits subject to change. The details of each parameter should be similarly descriptive and brief, and here you can also specify the parameter types and if they are required or not. For OpenTable, we can see that the query and location are the only required parameters when searching for restaurants, while all the additional filtering parameters like the date, time, or party size are optional, and the model will decide when to set them depending on the conversation. Once you have a plugin manifest, an open API specification, and your APIs available, you are now ready to submit your plugins to Bing Chat and the Copilot system. Now, Kyle will talk about how we're going to enable developers to submit their plugins and what happens next.
Thanks, Constantine. We'll have more details to share soon around how you can submit your plugin manifest directly into our catalog. Once your plugin is reviewed and approved, we're working to make sure users can discover and add your plugin to Bing Chat in Edge. To do this, we're adding new functionality to the Edge sidebar. I'm excited to preview for you a new sidebar experience, which you'll see beginning to roll out in Edge Insider builds this month. We're enhancing the plus button in the Edge sidebar to be the central place to find add-ons for your browsing and chat experiences in Edge, including new third-party sidebar apps, which you'll be hearing more about in other sessions at Build. Here, users can find a feed of recommended experiences from third-party developers and from Microsoft, now including chat plugins from our catalog. It's a snap for users to learn more about your plugin, add it to their account so they can access it in Bing Chat across their devices. Once you've added your plugin, it's ready to go anywhere you use Bing Chat, including Bing.com and the Edge sidebar. Let's look at a couple examples.
My friends are visiting this weekend, and it looks like it's going to be sunny, so I'm going to ask Bing to find a restaurant for us to enjoy the nice weather. I am in chat mode on Bing.com. You can see that the list of plugins I have installed and that are available for Bing Chat to use in this conversation. I am going to ask Bing to find me some restaurants with a view. These are all great options. I'm excited to check them out. You can see how the model automatically picks up the relevant plugin to use, in this case OpenTable, and suggests a couple of restaurants, while also adding a short description for each to help me decide. Similarly to the web search tool, Bing shows an interstitial to inform me about the plugin that was used. The summary for each of the restaurants highlights my requirements, and you can see how the model puts an emphasis on the atmosphere and the views each restaurant has. Okay, so Daniel Broilers in Lake Union seems like a cool place. I'm sure my friends are gonna like it. I'll ask Bing to help book something for Saturday. You can see that the model automatically picks up OpenTable again to check availability without me telling it to do that explicitly and comes back with a link to book. It already pre-populated the correct reservation details such as the group size and time. Now I can simply go ahead and book it directly on the OpenTable website with a single click. So we had a nice dinner the other day and I particularly enjoyed the dessert. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Of course, I could have used the traditional Bing image search here, but I wanted to show you one of the features we have already enabled in Bing Chat, the Bing Image Creator. This and search are native capabilities that are enabled by default, and with plugins we are making it easy for developers to further extend those skills and integrate their existing apps. Okay, so I'm not much of a cook, but this looks delicious, and I think I can pull it off and bake my own. So I'm asking Bing to find me a recipe, an easy one, for peach melba. Here are some options, and I'm going to click through the second one. This seems easy enough to follow. Now I can simply launch Bing Chat in the Edge sidebar to pick up the ingredients from the recipe. Bing Chat can automatically figure out the list because it has access to the web page content as it runs in the context of the current tab I am on. Okay, so this looks like all I need. I just remember I actually have some of these ingredients already, so I'm going to tell it which ones I don't need. Then I simply ask Bing Chat to generate a shopping list for me. Here, we see that since I had the Instacart plugin enabled, Bing Chat used it to create the shopping list for me. Now I can simply submit that list to Instacart and have all the groceries delivered to me in time for dinner. You can see how the traditional Instacart UI is still very useful, as it allows me to adjust the quantities and make product substitutions to the list that was automatically generated. This puts me, the user, in control of the final actions. That's the end of the demo. Now back to you, Kyle.
We'll have more to share soon about how you can publish your plugins into our catalog. In the meantime, developers can start building plugins for ChatGPT today, and those plugins will work in Bing Chat and across Microsoft's Copilot system. We can't wait to see the experiences that developers will light up with these revolutionary technologies. See you soon, and happy building.